Here in this video, we are concerned with the next family, that is family Liliaceae. As far as the family Liliaceae is concerned, it is a monocot family. The first three families are there. They are dicot families. For example, family Cisalpinaceae, Solanaceae and Nicteaginaceae. We were studied about that family. And these families are dicot families. Only one family in your syllabus, that is family Liliaceae, is a monocot family, belongs to class monocot of the Bentham and Hookers. Then, as far as the classification or systematic position of that family is concerned, no doubt the plants belongs to angiosperm, flowering plant, the class monocotyledoneae, because the plants are contains a reticular parallel venation, adventitious root system, seeds are having single cotyledon, then vascular bundles are irregularly spread in the ground tissue. These are some characters of the monocot: parallel venation, adventitious root system, single cotyledon in the leaves, vascular bundles are arranged in a irregular fashion in the stem, and the flowers are trimerous, not tetra or pentamerous. It is usually trimerous. Hence, the plant belongs to the monocot, family belongs to monocotyledon. And then order coronary. Coronary order simply having a single character, that is perianth is there. This perianth is a colored perianth. It is a bright perianth, bright colored perianth. Attractive perianths are there. That means all the flowers having an attractive perianth are placed under the coronary in case of monocots. That means important character is that there is no calyx or corolla differentiation. There is no calyx or corolla. Instead of that, there is a perianth. Only one ovule is there. It is called as perianth, and these perianths are attractive in color. Then family Liliaceae. This is the systematic position, that is division angiosperm, class monocotyledon. There is no subclass. Directly there is a series coronary and family Liliaceae. Then, as far as the distinguishing character of family, the families are having much more important plants, and due to that it is important family, and distinguishing characters are very simple. The family can easily identified with such a characters. First important character, the plants are herbs. They are perennial or sometimes annual herbs. Shrubs and climbers and trees are totally absent. That means plants are only herbs. They are small plants, green plants, and the plants are sometimes perennial herbs. That means they are lifelong, and all the life of that plants are more than 2 years, and some plants are annual years. Seasonal plants are there, and these plants are generally herbs. Then second character, stem mainly underground, and these underground stems are having a modification like a bulb, rhizome or tubers. That means stems are underground stems, and the stems are modified into bulbs, sometimes modified into a rhizome or sometimes modified into a tuber. For example, the good example of bulb is the onion. That means Allium sepa onion is a good example of the modification of stem bulb. As far as the tubers are concerned, Gloriosa superba is having a tuber. Some plants are having a rhizome. That means the stems are mainly underground, and when the modification contains a bulb, tubers or rhizome, the family is a Liliaceae. Then third character, leaves are having a parallel venation. They are importantly they are radical, or the base of that leaves is a cowline, and all leaves are having a parallel venation. A long, linear, slender leaves are there, and these leaves are having a cowline base, or these leaves are called as a radicular leaves. Then perianth, as far as the flower is concerned, the flowers may be having an inflorescence that is racemose type. Older flowers are at the base and younger flowers towards the apex, and these inflorescence contains attractive flowers. The perianths are attractive. A white, mostly it is a white color or having some other colors also, but the perianth is having 6 lobes arranged in a 2 ovules, that is called as 3+3. 3 lobes are outer and 3 lobes are inner, and the perianth is generally having a 6 lobes arranged in a 2 ovules. This is the diagnostic character about the perianth of that flower, and these flower perianths are always attractive in nature. mostly white in color. The stamens are 6. Ultimately, when the perianths are 6, ultimately stamens are 6, and these stamens are generally free, but sometimes they are conate at the base, that means fused at the base. Stamens are 6, they are free and sometimes conate at the base. Then last character, that is ovaries, are syncarpous, superior, tricarpellary with a axile placentation. That means ovaries are always having a tricarpellary, that means having a three locules or three carpels, and these three carpels are arranged in a axile placentation, and each locule contains a single ovule. That ovary is tricarpellary, syncarpous superior with a axile placentation. This is the important character, diagnostic character concerned with the gynoecium. These are the some diagnostic character or distinguishing characters of the family Liliaceae. Then there are some examples with economic importance. For example, first most important example is the Allium sepa. The botanical name is the Allium sepa. The English name is the onion, and the vernacular name is, it may be called as kanda or it may be called as pyaz. The Allium sepa is the botanical name of that plant. The plants are very important because it is commonly used as a vegetable. First important use is that they commonly used as a vegetable. Then along with that character, it is used as spice or condiment also. That means for the flavoring, flavor to food, it is used. Then the Allium sepa is used for increasing the urination. That means there are number of medicinal uses are also there. More urination is caused by this Allium sepa. Then bronchitis can be cured with that Allium sepa. Number of cardiac diseases, pulmonary diseases, heart diseases are controlled by that Allium sepa because it contains aspirin, and due to that it is used for the pulmonary diseases or are used to cure the pulmonary diseases or heart diseases also. Allium sepa again used as an antidote for a tobacco poisoning. That means there are number of medicinal uses. For example, more urination, used to control the bronchitis, used to control the cardiac diseases, pulmonary or heart diseases, and also used in number of skin diseases. Then this Allium sepa is used for the antidote to the tobacco poisoning. Then second important plant is there, that is Allium sativum. Allium sativum is a botanical name, and the common English name is the garlic, and common name it is called as lassan or lassoon. That means Allium sativum is nothing but the lassoon. This is vernacular name. The English name is the garlic, and this plant is also having an important value, important medicinal value. This plant is commonly cultivated as a condiment, as a spice. It is used in the spices and in the food preparations as a condiment or as a spice. Then this Allium sativum is used in most used in the number of heart diseases, pulmonary diseases, heart diseases, skin diseases. It is used in the cup, it is used in the piles, it is used in a number of heart diseases. It controls the cholesterol level of the body of the human. That means it contains a number of economic importance, for example condiments, then pulmonary, heart diseases, skin diseases, cups, piles. That means number of medicinal values are there concerned with the Allium sativum. Then third important plant, that is asparagus racemosus, commonly called as a shatavari. Vernacularly it is called as a shatavari. Asparagus racemosus is called as a shatavari. The plants are having a fasciculated tuberous roots present underground in the soil, and these fasciculated tuberous roots are economically very important. The leaves are needle shaped, spiny, or it may be of different shape, and the plants are generally herbs. The asparagus racemosus root powder is used as a nerve tonic. It is simply called as the preparation of shatavari kulp is made from this powder, root powder, and this shatavari kulp powder is used as a nerve tonic, or sometimes it is used for the body tonic also. It is used in number of this shatavari kulp is a tonic used in the nervous fitness and in the body fitness also. And it is used as an appetizer. That means it is used for the digestive, increasing the power of digestive system. Then the next plant is the Gloriosa superba. It is also called as Agnishika, or it is also called as Kalavi. And this Gloriosa superba has having attractive red colored or yellow colored flower. It is a wild plant. It is present in the forest, and it contains a tubers like a potato at the base. And these plants are also attractive plant, used ornamentally, or it is also used for the number of medicinal purposes. This is about the family Liliaceae, having some important plants like Allium sativum, Allium sepa, Asparagus racemosus. Aloe vera is also one important plant of this family. It is used in number of skin diseases. In the cosmetic industries, the value of aloe sepa is very much important. It is used in more number of stomach diseases also. Stomach ache or stomach troubles are also cured with help of this aloe vera. It is also called aloe barbadens. This is about the family Liliaceae.